Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today is the third Sunday of the Easter. We also commemorate this Sunday as ANZAC Day. ANZAC Day gives us a lot of memory, a lot of history to our present life. And Saturday marks the landing of Australian soldiers at Gallipoli on the shores of what is now ANZAC in Turkey on the 25th April 1950. Today many Australians and New Zealanders have gathered on those same shores to commemorate the memory and sacrifice of those who died so young. We also join with them to remember those who paid the ultimate price of the sacrifice of their lives. Through the celebration of the Eucharist, we gather to commemorate the sacrifice of Jesus, who offered his life in a death for all humanity. And now we have in our parish a ANZAC Day memorial book. In this book we have written the service people who have gone to offer their life to our country. We remember them in a special way today. And we pay our homage and respect.
Thank you.
Let us keep a minute silence now. Let us begin this month by recalling our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You will send him a contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You proceed at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your people accept forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11 and addressed the crowd in a loud voice. Men of Israel, listen to what I am going to say. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God by the miracles and portents and signs that God worked through him when he was among you, as you all know. This man, who was put into your power by the deliberate intention and foreknowledge of God, you took and had crucified by men outside the law. You killed him, but God raised him to life, freeing him from the pangs of Hades. For it was impossible for him to be held in its power, since, as David says of him, I saw the Lord before me always, for with him at my right hand nothing can shake me. So my heart was glad, and my tongue cried out with joy. My body too will rest in the hope that you will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor allow your Holy One to experience corruption. You have made known the way of life to me. You will fill me with gladness through your presence. Brothers, no one can deny that the patriarch David himself is dead and buried. His tomb is still with us. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn him an oath to make one of his descendants succeed him on the throne, what he foresaw and spoke about was the resurrection of the Christ. He is the one who was not abandoned to Hades and whose body did not experience corruption. God raised this man Jesus to life, and all of us are witnesses to that. Now raised to the heights by God's right hand, he has received from the Father the Holy Spirit, who was promised. And what you see and hear is the outpouring of that Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm. Lord, you will show us the path of life. Lord, you will show us the path of life. Preserve me, God. I take refuge in you. I say to the Lord, you are my God. O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup. It is you yourself who are my prize. Lord, you will show us the path of life. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm. Lord, you will show us the path of life. And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad, even my body shall rest in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead, nor let your beloved know decay. Lord, you will show us the path of life. You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence. At your right hand, happiness forever. Lord, you will show us the path of life. Second reading is from the letter of the first letter of St. Peter. You are acknowledging as your Father one who has no favourites and judges everyone according to what he has done. You must be scrupulously careful as long as you are living away from your home. Remember, the ransom that was paid to free you from the useless way of life your ancestors handed down was not paid in anything corrupt at all, neither in silver nor gold, but in the precious blood of a lamb without spot or stain, namely Christ, who, though known since before the world was made, has been revealed only in our time, the end of the ages, for your sake. Through him you now have faith in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory for that very reason, so that you would have faith and hope in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. Lord Jesus, make your word plain to us. Make our hearts burn with love when you speak. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
May the Lord bless you to proclaim the gospel to the Father, and the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Two of the disciples of Jesus were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem, and they were talking together about all that had happened. Now, as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side. But something prevented them from recognizing him. He said to them, "What matters are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped short, their faces downcast. Then one of them, called Cleopas, answered him, "You must be the only person staying in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have been happening there these last few days." "What things?" he asked. "All about Jesus of Nazareth," they answered, "who proved he was a great prophet by the things he said and did in the sight of God and of the whole people. And how our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death and had him crucified. Our own hope had been that he would be the one to set Israel free. And this is not all. 2 whole days have gone by since it all happened. And some women from our group have astounded us. They went to the tomb in the early morning, and when they did not find the body, they came back to tell us they had seen a vision of angels who declared he was alive. Some of our friends went to the tomb and found everything exactly as the woman had reported, but of him they saw nothing." And then he said to them, "You foolish men, so slow to believe the full message of the prophets. Was it not ordained that the Christ should suffer and so enter into his glory? Then, starting with Moses and going through all the prophets, he explained to them the passages throughout the scriptures that were about himself. When they drew near to the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on. But they pressed him to stay with them. 'It is nearly evening,' they said, 'and their day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. Now while he was with them at the table, he took the bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. But he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?' They set out that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, 'Yes, it is true, the Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon.' Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him in the breaking of bread." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The road to Emmaus tells the story of 2 disciples who unknowingly share their journey with Christ and experience all dimensions of well-being. The disciples had 2 wonderful experiences on their journey: burning of the heart by breaking of the word, opening of the inner eyes by breaking of the bread. Therefore, the road to Emmaus is a road of the breaking of the word and bread, and every day in the Eucharist we are experiencing. And the burning of the heart, it is an opening of the inner eyes. The road to Emmaus is a road to the Mount Horeb, Mount Tabor, ascending to the God's mountain. It's a road to the cenacle, it's a road to desert, it's a road to Jacob's well, it's a road to the prayer life, It is a road to the contemplative life. It is a road to the feet of Jesus. It is a road of mystical marriage. And according to St. Teresa, she says it is a road to the seventh mansion. These disciples, two of them, walk together and accompanied by Christ. So we put it as a physical well-being. They talked, listened, and told the story, an emotional well-being. They talked, listened, and told the story, an emotional well-being, and Christ interrupted scripture and told them an intellectual well-being. And Christ stayed with them, a social well-being. Christ broke bread with them and their eyes were opened, a spiritual wellness. Finally, he charged them to be witnesses, a occasional well-being. My dear brothers and sisters, we are out of shape physically, emotionally, and spiritually. We have not treated our bodies as a temple of the Holy Spirit. We have chosen to push, exhaust, stress, overextend, multitask and control, and not depend on God. We are all guilty and we are all forgiven. Let us seek, step by step, a centered, balanced life, physically, emotionally, intellectually, socially, spiritually, and occasionally. This was the experience of these two disciples. So let us claim the love of God through Christ in our lives. And know that Christ walks with us every step of the way, that it may be well with us. In the school of prayer, Jesus has mainly two lessons. The first one is perseverance, and the second is trust in God. When we pray, sometimes God will keep us in waiting. He does, but not because he is inconvenienced. When God keeps us waiting, it is for our good. The persistent prayer makes us cling to God. It makes us feel our state of insufficiency. After all, our sufficiency is from God. Prayer has also this value, even to wait his grace. It makes us look up to God always, talk to him and go to him and not to him. Therefore, discover and follow Christ through the transforming prayer power. May God bless you, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we have the church notification, the church offering by electronic deposit. You may find now in the slide, a regular church offering and planned giving scheme. Manager of parish check account, details are given. So kindly put your envelope number and surname, or just surname. Thank you very much. the profession of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried, He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. On the way to Emmaus, Jesus unlocked the scriptures for the two disciples. Then revealed Himself in the breaking of bread. As we long to be fed again from the tables of word and sacrament, let us pray for a world hungry for good news.
We pray for our spiritual leaders within the Church, that they will continue to find peace and refreshment during this Easter season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all men and women in our Defence Force who served and bravely lost their lives during times of conflict, especially members of the Australian and New Zealand Army Corps. May they rest in the peace of Christ and rise in glory on the last day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families who lost loved ones through war, may the light of God's hope and strength comfort them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all political leaders. May the Holy Spirit help them to make wise decisions and to build relationships that lead to peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those whose mental health is under threat from confinement and social isolation. May they find the resources they need to keep their peace of mind. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the recently deceased, especially those who have died from the coronavirus, and for those whose anniversary of death occurs around this time. May they join the risen Lord and all the saints in the glory of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let's also pray for our own personal intentions. Loving Father, we ask that you hear our prayer and grant our petitions. As we continue to remember the true meaning of Easter, in the power of the Spirit and the name of your obedient Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Robed in flesh, I'll make thy praise.
Grant also that the gifts of the bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. This be ours through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is to the right and just. Our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time all to love you, and more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and also the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is a ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of last risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gerard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and those who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. And mention us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs in our life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold thee, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter my house, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
the heavy loads. He beside them as they talked about on earth. What he had to say set their hearts aflame. Their eyes were opened when he blessed and broke the bread. Lord, arisen, I can't believe my eyes, my joy will fulfill me until you come again. Trembling in their room, that same afternoon, he came among them saying, peace be with you. See my hands and feet, touch my side and feet. Go now and tell all nations what you see and hear. Lord, arisen, I can't believe my eyes, my joy will fulfill me until you come again. Please come again. Please come again.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Now let us sing our national anthem, Australia Fair.
Let us rejoice, for we are young and free.